7 and 8. This diagram not necessary. All of these diagrams you will draw next time, in time of our classes. We start from circulation of fluids. You have received this diagram also in time of your lecture, I think. But I repeat, that is placenta. Do you know that in placenta, blood of mother not mixed with the blood of fetus, yes, and it is take place exchange of gases, and oxygenated blood through umbilical vein go to fetus through umbilical cord. That is liver, and it is portal vein, vena porta. 1, 2, 3. An umbilical vein, vena umbilicalis, inflow into portal vein, and from umbilical vein start duct, ductus venosus, and this duct attached to inferior vena cava, which blood in inferior vena cava? Deoxygenated. It is oxygenated blood. And in place where ductus venosus attached to inferior vena cava, blood mixed in this place. And oxygenated blood passed through liver, and from liver, vena, help me, what is it? Vena hepatica, inflow into inferior vena cava, and it is blood also mixed one again. And inferior vena cava, olabisi, inflow into what? Olabisi. Inferior vena cava, inflow into? Right atrium. And from right atrium, through foramen ovale, blood go to left atrium, and from left atrium into left ventricle, and from left ventricle into aorta. Now, from spiruvina cava, blood go into the right ventricle. It is deoxygenated blood, and from right ventricle start what? Pulmonary trunk, and pulmonary trunk divides into two pulmonary arteries. But in time of development of fetus, not necessary to for passage of blood through lungs. That is why from pulmonary trunk start ductus arteriosus, and this duct carry venous blood, deoxygenated blood, into aorta, and it is blood mixed one again. And this ductus arteriosus inflow into aorta below of the level of left subclavial artery. It is brachiocephalic trunk, left common carotid, and left subclavial. And ductus arteriosus inflow in below of subclavial arteries. That is why head and upper extremity receive blood which reach with the oxygen than trunk and lower extremity. Clear why? Because part of venous blood deoxygenated inflow into aorta below from the level of subclavial arteries. And then blood which pour with the oxygen pass through aorta, common iliac, external and internal iliac arteries, and from internal iliac artery start arteria umbilicalis. Arteria umbilicalis goes to umbilical cord and carry blood to placenta. Clear? Names all of these arteries, heat is present, that is why you prepare only small moment. Heat is not so exact, that is ductus arteriosus in this diagram, inflow into aorta, not below of subclavial vein. At my diagram, more exact, heat is below from the level of subclavial artery. Clear? That is first diagram. Next. It is superior vena cava. It is brachiocephalic vein. and brachiocephalic vein formed with the help of what? Internal jugular and subclavial. Heat is also internal jugular and subclavial. Heat is inferior vena cava. Heat is common iliac veins. Common, inferior vena cava receive vena lumbalis. Heat is vena lumbalis ascendens. And it go into vena azygos. Heat is vena hemiazygos and heat is hemiazygos accessorium. And we receive anastomosis between superior and inferior vena cava, where heat is blood from vena lumbalis going to inferior vena cava, but also blood can pass through vena lumbalis ascendens into vena azygos and go to superior vena cava. Name of this anastomosis, caval anastomosis on posterior abdominal wall. Yeah. I continue to draw. Heat is. Now we have this diagram. Now I continue to draw anastomosis in the region of vertebral plexus. Heat is. Plexus vertebralis. We have two types of vertebral plexus, internal and external. Internal inside of vertebral column, external outside of it. And from vertebral plexus start vena intervertebralis. And in cervical department, vena intervertebralis inflow into vena... What is it? Into vena vertebralis, that is vena intervertebralis, they go into vena vertebralis, and vena vertebralis go into vena brachiocephalic, and brachiocephalic into superior vena cava. Clear. In thoracic department, that is vena, what is it? Intercostalis posterioris. And vena intervertebralis in thoracic department, go into vena intercostalis, and heat is also into vena intercostalis. At your diagram, not so clear, it should be, that is, vena intervertebralis, they should inflow into vena intercostalis. Clear? Heat is also vena intervertebralis, go into vena intercostalis. And in lumbar department, vena intervertebralis go into vena lumbalis. Go into vena lumbalis. And we receive anastomosis in the region of vertebral plexus. Blood, part of the blood, go into the region of superior vena cava, but from lumbar department, blood go into the region of inferior vena cava. Caval anastomosis in the region of vertebral plexus. Clear? Next, that is, one again, superior vena cava, brachiocephalic vein, internal jugular, subclavial, and subclavial, it is continuation of axillary, that is axillary, heat is subclavial, internal jugular, brachiocephalic, and superior vena cava. Here, vena cava inferior, vena iliaca communis, vena iliaca interna, vena iliaca externa, an external iliac vein, that is continuation of femoral vein. In the region of anterior abdominal wall, we have network, venous network, and blood from this venous network pass downward through vena epigastrica inferior and it go into vena iliaca externa. And vena epigastrica superficialis go into vena femoralis. Upward, vena epigastrica superior continue into internal thoracic. Okay, vena thoracica interna inflow into vena Brachiocephalic. Into brachiocephalic vein. Here it is vena thoraca epigastrica continue into vena thoracica lateralis and vena thoracica lateralis into axillary vein. What we receive? We receive anastomosis between system of superior and inferior vena cava on anterior abdominal wall. Cava, caval anastomosis on anterior abdominal wall. But if we draw, here it is liver, here it is portal vein. From this network, we have vena paraumbilicalis, which go into vena porta. And what we receive? We receive porta, cava, caval anastomosis, and blood from anterior abdominal wall also can pass through portal vein. Look at your manual. It is cava, caval anastomosis. And then the same diagram, add liver and receive porta, cava, caval anastomosis. That is two diagrams, but here it is absent liver. We speak about cava, caval on anterior abdominal wall. Here it is porta, cava, caval anastomosis on anterior abdominal wall. Next. Liver, portal vein, here it is stomach. From lesser cavity of the stomach, we have artery, vein. What is this vein? Vena gastrica sinistra, which go to vena porta. And from esophagus, blood go. Emeka, you answer the blackboard. Vena esophagalis go into vena azygos. Here it is esophageal veins, vena esophagalis, and they go into vena azygos. And vena azygos inflow into superior vena cava. And we have anastomosis in the region of abdominal part of esophagus and cardiac part of the stomach. Anastomosis in the abdominal part of esophagus. That is porta caval anastomosis. Blood go into portal vein and blood from esophagus go into azygos vein and azygos into superior vena cava. Next. That is inferior vena cava. It is common iliac. It is vena. Lumbalis. Vena lumbalis. It is cecum, colon ascendens. It is colon descendens. Blood from colon ascendens pass through vena colica dextra into vena mesenterica superior. From colon descendens, vena colica sinistra into vena mesenterica inferior. It is vena lienalis together from portal vein and portal vein go to liver, yes? That is portal vein. But also blood from ascendens and descendens colon can pass into inferior vena cava. And we receive porta caval anastomosis in the region of ascendens and descendens colon.
Can pass into vena cava through lumbalis.
Yes, through vena lumbalis into inferior vena cava. Main way into superior and inferior vena cava into portal vein, main way. But if we have problems with liver, for example, cirrhosis, and connective tissue developed in liver and blocked passage of blood through portal vein, in this case, blood can go into inferior vena cava directly without portal vein, with the help of this anastomosis. And last diagram. Here it is, liver, portal vein. Here it is, inferior vena cava, common iliac veins, internal and external. And here it is rectum. Internal iliac vein give vena pudenda, so receive vena pudenda interna. And from inferior part of rectum, vena rectalis inferior inflow into vena pudenda interna. Vena rectalis media inflow into vena iliaca interna. And vena rectalis superior go to vena
mesenteric inferior.
Here it is mesenterica superior, and here it is vena lianalis, and go into portal vein. And we receive porta caval anastomosis in the region of rectum. That is in the region of gastric and esophagus, ascending and descending colon, and anastomosis in the region of rectum. It is not so exact. That is internal iliac vein and vena. It is It is clear, vena rectalis superior into mesenterica inferior, vena rectalis media into iliaca interna, and here it is vena pudenda interna, that is internal iliac, here it is pudenda interna, and vena rectalis inferior into vena pudenda interna. Clear? Not make here it is mistake. Necessary to correct, draw, like he it is. That is all H diagrams. All of them, yes. On Monday, yes. On Monday. You will draw only two. Everybody will draw two diagrams on Monday.
Which are the two?
No,
you land it to no.
I don't know.